Good morning, Honorable. Myself, P. Rajmani, from Mechanical Department at St. Martin's Engineering College. In this semester, I am dealing with renewable energy sources subject for final year second semester. So, look at this. This is the syllabus for renewable energy sources. So, first we go for first unit. Here, look at this. This is the first unit. Here, global and national energy scenario. In first unit, just we learn the what are the types of renewable energy sources and what is the difference between renewable energy sources and what are non-renewable energy sources. And after that, we learn the what is the potential of renewable energy sources. And next, to move on to the second unit. And here, second unit also we learn the solar energy sources. And next, move on to the third unit. Here we learn the wind turbines, how by using wind turbines how to get the electricity. So that is the wind energy. And we move on to the fourth unit. Here fourth unit is biogas. We have so many topics of the in the biogas. So here we learn the biogas classification and biochemical classification and bioenergy programming in India. So in fourth unit totally we learn the by using biogas how to get the electrical energy. And next move on to the fifth unit. Here we fifth unit is ocean energy. Here also we are getting the electrical energy. So in the ocean, by using ocean energy, how to get the electrical energy. In the in this subject, totally we learn the electrical energy by using renewable energy sources. In renewable energy source, so look at this. This is the first of all. Before going to the RES means renewable energy sources, first we learn the energy. So what is mean by energy? So energy is the amount of force or power when apply can move one object from one position to another position. So we first we have to apply the force. So how to move the thing one place to another place. So that is called as energy. Look at this. For example, we are taking the here when you charge your mobile phone, the electrical energy is converted into the chemical energy, so which gets stored inside the battery. For example, in renewable energy sources, in renewable energy sources, basically we are convert the one form of energy into the another form of energy. So that is called as renewable energy sources. So here, energies are broadly classified into main two groups. First one, renewable energy sources, and the second one, non-renewable energy sources. Look at this. Renewable energy sources means very natural sources without pollution. So in renewable energy sources, we have a five types. First one, solar energy system, and second one, wind energy system, and third one, ocean thermal energy system, and fifth one, thermal energy system, and fifth one, biomass or biogas energy systems. Okay, these are the renewable energy sources. These five renewable energy sources we are using, we are getting the electricity. In this subject, mainly we are getting the electricity from the renewable energy sources. So these five are we are using the natural energy sources, we are getting the electricity. So first move on to the solar energy system. Here this is the in this solar energy system we have so many types. In the solar energy system we using photovoltaic conversion system and solar thermal conversion systems. So that two systems are we are using and we are getting the electricity. And next to move on to the wind energy. In wind energy we have two types of wind turbines. First one horizontal wind turbine and second one vertical wind turbine. If by using these wind turbines, we are getting the electricity and electricity. And next move on to the ocean thermal energy. Here we have a ocean thermal means here we are using water components. Here we are using water. Water is the components of the ocean thermal energy system. Here we learn the small hydropower plants. And next move on to the geothermal energy system. And next move on to the biomass or biogas energy system. Here we learn the biogas gasifiers that are the components of the biogas energy systems. So what is the advantages of the total renewable energy systems? So these fiber whatever may be, we have a renewable energy sources that all are widely availability, and cost is very low because of that all renewable energy sources are available naturally. So there is no pollution in the environmental conditions. So decentralization power production, we are using these four or five renewable energy sources. Obviously we are getting the power or electricity, and low pollution available for the for assemble for future. These all are available for future also. Next, non-renewable energy sources. Here look at these non-renewable sources is a natural sources that can't be remade or grown at a scale comparable to its consumptions. Here means, look at this. This means in renewable energy sources we are remade again and again, but in non-renewable resources we are not we can't remade. Why? Because of these all are the fossil fuels. Here in fossil fuels we have a types: petrol, diesel and coal and mining. So these are non-renewable resources are very costly, and these resources are very polluted in the environmental conditions. So that's why non-renewable resources are can't be remade. So next one. So after that, first we go for renewable energy sources. First we go for wind energy. So what is mean by wind energy? What is the working of the wind energy? We learn. Look at this. Here wind energy means kinetic energy is converted into electrical energy. So what is the formula of the kinetic energy? So we learn working principle of the wind energy. The wind power can be gained by making it blow past the blades that will causes the rotor to twist. Here means, look at, in wind power means wind turbine blades all are connected to the rotor. So in the rotor motion is converted into the kinetic energy. The kinetic energy is converted into the electrical energy. So that is the basic principle of the wind turbine or wind energy conversion system. So look at this. The amount of power transmission is directly proportional to the density of the head. Here the power of the wind turbine is directly proportional to the density of the head. So here the power is totally depends upon the head. So here power is equal to half rho pi r square and v cube. Here means, look at, p, total amount of power is transferred directly proportional to the density of the air. Means the in wind turbines, kinetic energy is converted into the electrical energy. In kinetic energy we have a formula that is called as half mv square. So m means mass ratio of the air, and v means velocity of the wind turbine blade. So look at this. In mass is equal to AB into rho A is equal to VW. Here means mass is equal to turbine blade area into density of the blade and velocity of the turbine blade. So AB is equal to turbine blade area is equal to pi d square. Here means look at the, so we are substituting the all the formulas in the power. Okay, P is equal to half rho into pi r square b cube. So here pi r means blade area and rho means density of the blade, b means velocity of the turbine blade. So this is the total power or kinetic energy or electrical energy of the turbine blade, and this is the working principle of the turbine blade. So basic components of the wind energy conversion system. So this is the block diagram of the wind energy conversion system. Look at this. This is the aero turbine and the gearing, coupling, electrical generator. Okay, here look at this. First, wind is the connected into the aero turbine. Aero turbine means here total aero turbine means total blades of the wind is that is called as aero turbine. The aero turbine is connected to the gearing. Here the gearing is functioning the movement of the turbine blades. And here coupling, the gearing is connected into the coupling. Here coupling is to connect the gearing and the electrical generator. Here the electrical generator, what is the electrical generator purpose? Here kinetic energy is, the generator is convert the electrical kinetic energy into the electrical energy. And the last one, to load or and the grid. Here we are move on to the, here we store the energy of the wind turbine. And look at this. This is the wind speed, pitch control. First one, wind direction. Wind direction means yaw control. Yaw control means to control the movement of the blades. And pitch control, to control the movement of the rotation of the shaft. And speed and torque. Here we have to calculate the speed and torque by using the movement of the shaft. And here the speed and torque is connected into the controller, and controller signal is connected into the controller, and speed also connected into the controller. Here what is the control role of the wind turbine? To control the total movement of the wind turbines. So that is called as wind controller. Okay, here the wind controller is connected to the output power. So here to load or until grid, here total wind turbine power is stored in the load or circuit grid. Next, move on to the next slide. So aero turbine, here the aero turbine is to convert the wind energy into the rotary motion. Gearing is speed of the turbine shaft, and the coupling to connect the gear shaft to generator shaft, and here generator to convert the mechanical energy into the electrical energy. Basically in we are getting the mechanical energy into the electrical energy. Look at this. This is the very very important part of the wind energy turbine. Here last component of the wind turbine, the controller. What is the controller perform? Means here to perform the functions of the total wind turbine, or to control the total running of the wind turbine. Okay, first function, what is the orientation of the rotor into wind? That is called as yaw control. And start up and cut into off equipment. So that is called as overload or grid. So to start up or to cut into the speed of the wind turbine. And power control of rotor by varying pitch of blade. Generator output, data consumption and data storage. These three are, it's linked with the generator in the wind turbine. And next move on to the shutdown at very high speed. So this means to cut the to stop the overflow of the wind turbine. And the maintenance mode means here to maintain the total overview of the turbine blade. So look at this. This is the diagram of the wind turbine. So these all parts are to connect the wind turbine. So look at this. The rotor is connected to the So these are the all parts of the wind turbines. So already we are completed in the block diagram. So working of the wind turbine. So I hope you all are understood. Thank you, guys.